Welcome to an interstellar journey out of our solar system and into our galaxy. In our previous video, we talked about the incredible distances and scales of our Earth, Moon, Sun, planets, and solar system. But get ready. We're going to go far beyond these distances and explore our galaxy on an interstellar journey. In this video, we will first visit nearby stars and then continue our journey deeper into the Milky Way. If you remember in the previous video, the distances we talked about were always expressed in terms of miles, kilometers, or astronomical units for the distance between the Earth, the Sun, and the planets. But in this video, we are going to go much farther and explore such gigantic cosmic structures that the distance and size units we used in the previous video will become useless. So, for the interstellar journey in this video, and the intergalactic journey in the next video, we will use the light year, the most commonly used distance unit on the cosmic scale. So, what exactly is a light year? Actually, the answer to the question is hidden in its name. Light year is the distance traveled by light for 1 year. We call the basic particle that makes up the light a photon. A photon particle moves so fast that its speed in space is approximately 186,000 miles, or 300,000 kilometers per second. This is an inconceivable speed, and is known as the highest speed limit in the universe. Now that we know the speed of light, let's calculate how much distance the light year is in kilometers and miles. Since the speed of light travels 186,000 miles, or 300,000 kilometers per second, we need to calculate how many seconds a year is before we can find the distance it takes in a year. A year is 365 days. Each day is 24 hours, each hour is 60 minutes, and each minute is 60 seconds. When we multiply all these values, we calculate that 1 year is 31,536,000 seconds. And then we multiply this value by 186,000 miles, or 300,000 kilometers, the distance traveled by light in 1 second. We find 5.88 trillion miles, or 9.46 trillion kilometers, the distance traveled by light in 1 year. We can roughly call this distance 6 trillion miles, or 10 trillion kilometers. In the following parts of our video, we will now use the light year measure when expressing distances. Because we are gradually moving away from the solar system and traveling towards interstellar space, and from this point on, distances will no longer be difficult to express in kilometers or miles, so we will use the light year measure when specifying distances. The first star system we encounter after leaving the solar system is Alpha Centauri. Although Alpha Centauri looks like a single star to the naked eye from Earth, it is actually a system of three stars. Another name of this system is Rigel Centaurus. The system consists of two large stars orbiting each other every 80 years, and a smaller star orbiting them. The star that is similar to our Sun and slightly larger than it is called Alpha Centauri A. And the star that is slightly smaller and colder than our Sun is called Alpha Centauri B. Proxima Centauri, the smallest member of the system, is the closest star to the solar system. Proxima Centauri is 4.24 light years away, while the other two stars are 4.37 light years from us. If we visualize this distance as follows, if a passenger plane were to travel to this star system, this journey would take 6 million years. This is such a long distance that even light reaches these stars in a little more than 4 years. In other words, we see these stars as they were about 4 years ago. Astronomers can calculate the distance of stars relatively close to us using a method called parallax. We will explain how this calculation is done in detail in another video. Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf star and is a very small star compared to the Sun. A little bigger than Jupiter, Proxima Centauri is also much cooler and dimmer than the Sun. Since the mass of such red dwarf stars is very small, they carry out fusion reactions very slowly, and this causes the hydrogen in their structure to be depleted later. Therefore, the lifetime of red dwarf stars can be up to 100 billions or even several trillion years. Another interesting statistic is that red dwarf stars are the most populous type of stars in the universe, making up 70% of all stars in the universe. Red dwarf stars like Proxima Centauri are so faint that it is impossible to see them with the naked eye. After traveling a little further away from Alpha Centauri, we come across another close star, Barnard's Star, Barnard's star is also a red dwarf star, and it is impossible to see it with the naked eye. Barnard is 5.96 light years away and is a single star. Sirius is undoubtedly the star that has fascinated mankind the most in the night sky throughout history. Thanks to its brightness, many civilizations have considered this star sacred and used it as a measure when determining their calendars. Sirius is 8.6 light years away from us and is actually a binary star system. The larger and brighter of the stars, Sirius A has twice the mass of the Sun and is 25 times brighter. Sirius A is a white main sequence star, young and short-lived. Sirius A's companion star, Sirius B, is a white dwarf star left over from a dying star. Although Sirius can be recognized with the naked eye, this binary star system can only be distinguished with a good telescope. We continue our space journey by slowly moving away from the Sun and stars close to the Sun. The Sun is just one of the 100 to 400 billion stars in the Milky Way galaxy. When you go to a rural place away from the light pollution caused by city lights, you will notice a pale cloud-like structure that crosses the sky from one end to the other. This structure is the Milky Way galaxy, a collection of billions of stars and interstellar gas and dust. Our Sun is also located in this gigantic structure. Have you ever thought about how many stars you can see when you look at the night sky? And how far away are the most distant stars that we can see with the naked eye? When you look at the sky at night, we can see about 3,000 stars. If you take into account that about 3,000 stars can be observed in the other hemisphere, a total of about 6,000 stars can be observed. Most of these stars are within a diameter of about 1,000 light years. Exceptionally, a few of the most distant stars visible to the naked eye are located between 1,500 and 2,000 light years away. Even a very large and bright star like Deneb is 2,600 light years away from us. Our Sun is located in an intermediate arm of the Milky Way galaxy called the Orion Spur, which lies between the Sagittarius and Perseus arms. Many famous stars such as Betelgeuse, Vega, and Sirius are also located in this region. The Sun is located 26,000 light years from the center of the Milky Way. The Sun is not very close to the center of the Milky Way, towards its outer edge, but it is still in the spiral arms of the galaxy. The Sun completes an orbit around the center of the Milky Way in about 225 to 250 million years. During its entire lifetime, the Sun has made 22 revolutions around the center of the Milky Way galaxy. The Sun moves at a speed of about 828,000 kilometers per hour during this tour. Since the distances within the galaxy are very large, it is impossible to perceive this speed of the Sun within the galaxy with the naked eye. These speeds can only be detected with very advanced observation instruments. You can think of why you cannot perceive this speed as follows. When we are in an aeroplane, except for takeoff and landing, we can never perceive that the aeroplane is traveling at a speed of 800 kilometers per hour. Therefore, we cannot perceive this speed when the Sun is traveling in the Milky Way together with all the other planets. The Milky Way galaxy, which contains 100 billion stars, is estimated to be between 1 to 2 trillion solar masses, including dark matter. At the center of the galaxy is a supermassive black hole that holds the entire galaxy together. The mass of this black hole, called Sagittarius A star, is about 4 million solar masses. Its diameter is about 15 million miles or 24 million kilometers, and together with the accretion disk around it, it covers an area less than the diameter of Mercury's orbit. It is hard to imagine how much gravitational attraction is created by such a large mass gathered in such a narrow space. So great a gravitational pull that even light cannot escape this black hole. The interstellar medium spread throughout the galaxy consists of sparse gases, mostly hydrogen and helium, and microscopic dust. This environment of gas and dust is mostly the remains of dead stars, which come together in certain regions under the influence of gravity to form new stars. These gas and dust structures absorb or scatter the light from the stars in the galaxy, making it impossible to observe the very distant realms of our galaxy from our Earth. The hazy and cloudy structure that we see at night is formed by the combination of these gas and dust clouds and the stars in the galaxy. If we had the chance to go far away from our sun and go beyond our galaxy, we would be able to see that these gas and dust structures are arranged in spiral arms that form the shape of the Milky Way. You may wonder how we know this structure of the Milky Way galaxy without traveling outside it. Astronomers can only map this structure with advanced radio and infrared telescopes by calculating the gas and dust cloud structures and the distances to the stars. Many observations have shown that our galaxy is ultimately a barred spiral. It is estimated to be about 100,000 light years across from one end to the other. When viewed from the side, the Milky Way looks like a thin disk with a bulging center. Recent observations by Gaia, ESA's observation satellite, have revealed that our galaxy is not a flat disk, but is actually bent at its edges. This bending is thought to be caused by satellite galaxies around the Milky Way. The central region of the disk, where it bulges, is 3,000 light years thick, while towards the edges, it is about 1,000 light years thick. If we were to travel at the speed of light from one end of our galaxy to the other, it would take 100,000 years, while traveling just outside the disk would take 1,000 years. Now, we are slowly moving away from our galaxy Milky Way. In the next video, we will go much further beyond our galaxy and explore the local group of satellite, dwarf galaxies, and the Andromeda Galaxy. The journey won't stop there, and we'll go beyond the local group to explore clusters of galaxies, huge cosmic networks, and reach the edge of the visible universe. If you haven't seen the first video of this journey, you can watch it from the link in the description or end of the video. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and press the notification bell. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.